Now, you see, here we are dealing with a new topic, organism and population. Now, organism and population. Population means we are dealing with the whole community. Okay, that I'll come to the later part. First is organism. Okay. Now, every organism lives in an environment. Okay, so environment basically, it is an integral part that is most essential for the survival of the organism. That means what? The environment includes the surrounding. Okay, now you see, if we take it in the form of a schematic diagram, this whole square includes the environment. Okay, so in this particular environment, see, the circle represents the habitat. Now, what is habitat? Habitat is the place where an organism lives. For example, this is the area occupied by many organisms. And here, it is a particular place, you see, where an individual organism lives. See, here the whole, for example, if we talk of crow. So, this entire big circle represents the living place of a crow. And this is the place where a single crow lives. Okay, others live in. So, that particular place where the organism shares the ecosystem in a balanced way, that means particular individual is in a balance with the surrounding. For example, I tell you, if your house, for example, the place, your house is your habitat, okay, but your study room is your niche, okay. Now, if we consider the environment, we have certain factors related to the environment. So, what are the basic factors? You see, you have the biotic factor and the abiotic factor related to the environment. Okay. So, this biotic factor and abiotic factor, again, if they are in harmony, we call it as an ecosystem. Okay. Now, biotic means the living part. So, what are the living part of this environment? See, you have, or the ecosystem is the various biome. What are the biome? The geographical condition. You may either have a desert area, you may either have a grassland, you may either have a mountain, you may either have a forest, pond or sea. And the abiotic factor is water, light, temperature, soil. So, these abiotic factors play a very, very important role in the life of the organism that helps it to cope with the surrounding. Okay, so this coping with the surrounding, if the organism successfully copes with the surrounding, we call it as adaptation. Okay, now if we deal with adaptation, adaptation basically is adjusting. Okay. Now, we will come across three factors. Now, this adaptation is adjustment to the surrounding. So, this adjustment, you know, the internal well-being, the internal system of the organism has to adapt with the external environment. You see, internal environment has to adjust with the external environment. Now, why the internal has to adjust with the external? Because internal and external, if they do not adjust, the organism will not be at a stable state. For example, if the weather is very cold, if the weather is very cold, external environment is very cold, and the internal reaction within the body, for example, is not able to adjust, If you see on a very cold day, you feel like having a hot cup of tea or a milk or whatever. But even if you are not able to adjust, you start shivering. It is a reaction. That means you are unable to adjust to the environment, the external environment. Now you see, when the organism is trying to adjust to the external environment, we call it as homeostasis. Homeostasis. Now what is homeostasis? Homeostasis is actually the innate quality of an organism to adjust to the environment. Okay. Now, if we consider the internal environment, see these are four factors. Regulate, confirm, migrate and suspend. Now what is regulate? The body tries to adjust with the external environment. Okay. Now, confirm is body cannot adjust. You, for example, you see that means it cannot handle the stress of the environment. You see very few species, very few animals you find in the polar region. Very few of them you find in deserts. So that is why these organisms cannot adjust to certain harsh climate. Then comes migrate. Now, organism to adjust to the environment, to survive, they have to migrate if they cannot tide over certain stressful condition. For example, you see Arctic and Antarctic zone. Now, this Arctic area, the organisms are face very adverse climate. Okay, the climate is very harsh. It is minus 0 degrees, the freezing time. So these organisms, that particular area is no longer safe for them and their babies. So to adjust to the changing climate, they have to tide over it. Tide over means they move away to another place that is not as severe as their particular place, and until the season changes, they stay over there. So migratory birds are example of how organisms migrate. Now again, if you see in certain parts of Africa, especially Itosa, you know that before the rain comes, the plateau dries up so severely that all the organism means all the animals, especially the grass eating animal, Itosa plateau is very famous for your zebras, rhinos, buffaloes, okay, and even the tigers also. So they move to water holes until the rain comes back. So that is how is an example of mine. And you know, some organisms, especially the very lower, that means the bacteria and virus, what do? When the favorable condition is not there, they suspend their body activity. For example, amoeba. Okay, when the surrounding is becoming dry, they cannot have a certain food material, plenty food supply is cut down. So what do? They form a cyst, encystment you call it. They form a cyst, and within the cyst, they undergo multiple fission and they stay there only. Now when the favorable season comes, this water comes, it swells up and it burst opens, and all these minute daughter amoeba, they come out, okay, and they come out and they start a new life when the conditions are favorable. So this is how the organism suspend their body activities and they go to it. So that when these things are favorable, the internal and the external environment becomes normal, the organism is adapted to the surrounding.